So through the course of this dispute, a lot of people have tried to offer their solutions, their ideas. One such person who also, in fact, a part of a Muslim brotherhood, a Muslim group of intellectuals who were trying to offer a solution is Lieutenant General Zameer Uddin Shah. Lieutenant General Shah, welcome to NDTV. My first question to you is, you know, you have always believed that attempting to find a solution in this case is very important because, as you said in the past also, this seems to be a losing argument for the Muslims. So what, according to you, was the best thing to do instead of contesting this in court?
No, I don't think there's a losing argument. Mm-hmm. I think it is an argument for sensibility. I mean, for using senses, I feel that in a court verdict, there'll be a winner and a loser. We should not have any losers. We should all have winners. And I say never give up. I am aware that this is rather late in the day, but still we have never given up. And we feel that an out-of-court settlement would be the best for the country, for the amity of the country, and for increasing the Muslim-Hindu brotherhood.
Mm-hmm. Now, Lieutenant General Shah, there are reports coming in that the mediation panel report has been submitted. And one of the points that is being spoken about, and this is by way of sources, is that the Sunni Waqf Board will not have any objection in handing over or allowing the government to acquire the site. Do you see this as some sort of a breakthrough? However, there is a rider. Not all stakeholders agree to this solution.
Well, certainly, this offer is very sensible. But what you have not mentioned is the riders. The two important riders are, firstly, there should be no repeat of what happened in Ayodhya. The Muslims want cast iron guarantees that this will never happen again. And secondly, what we want is the teeth should be given to the Preservation of Places of Worship Act, the Amendment Act 1991. I think it does not have teeth enough. It is a very weak law, and anybody can violate it with impunity. So we want it to become more stringent. I think in case these two things are met, the Muslim personal law, the people who have agreed to hand over the land are well within their rights. That is the Sunni Waqf Board. Mm.
Now, Lieutenant General Shah, your own suggestion that the land be gifted for the construction of a temple to the majority community has been greeted with a lot of skepticism, particularly by stakeholders in the Muslim side. Were you expecting this, and do you feel that this will only go ahead and create animosity and not find an amicable solution?
I was expecting a backlash. I have received a lot of messages saying that what I am wrong. But what they don't know is that 10 times more I have received messages of support from a wide cross-section of Muslims who do not want to come out openly. But they have sent me messages saying that the stand we have taken for a compromise, for amity, for peace in the country is absolutely correct.
Well, the Muslim stakeholders, Lieutenant General Shah, say that mediation cannot mean that we give up our claim. How would you respond to that? Because the feeling is that they're giving up. They're giving up the fight.
No, we are not giving up the fight. We are adopting a sensible approach. Giving up a fight is in case you win and then are not able to reconstruct the mosque, which I have told them is an impossibility. That would be giving up. That would be surrender. After winning, surrender. Before a court verdict, If we reach an agreement, it is not giving up the fight. It is just a move towards peace and amity.
All right. Lieutenant General Shah, my final question to you before I let you go. There are, in fact, murmurs that usually when people try mediating and try offering solutions, perhaps, and more so in a case like this, they may be doing it out of some interest, political interest, if you were, particularly in this case. Have you ever been pressurized or told to say what you do or the suggestion that you give by a particular political party or political interests?
Let me make it clear. I have never been pressurized right during my service of 40 years in the army, and also when I was Vice Chancellor of Aligarh Muslim University, because people know me well enough. I will not, I repeat, never and not ever succumb to pressure.
All right. Lieutenant General Shah, we leave it there. Thank you so much for joining us right here on NDTV.